Hi and welcome to my video series on noise desensitisation. This is the introduction. I thought this was a great opportunity to shoot this video series live. Koji's just coming into his second blow, and so I thought this year I'm going to be a little bit more ready than I was last year. So I purchased a pet grooming blower, combination dryer, off the internet, and because of where we are at the moment, we have access to a vacuum, which is something we don't normally have living on the road. So I thought I might try and utilize both of those into getting his coat blow under control. And I turned it on yesterday and tried to use it on him, the vacuum on him, and he got a little bit anxious and stepped away. And he's not scared of the noise. I've done a lot of work with him since we got him on calming and so forth, and because of the lifestyle that we live, he's continually been introduced to new things nearly every day. So, you know, so he goes from one extreme to another and just handles it all really well. But there was some anxiety there and he wasn't real happy, and I don't believe in stressing a dog for the sake of stressing a dog, so I thought it was a good opportunity to desensitise him to it. And at the same time, to film it live to help other people, because it's a common thing with people having trouble with. And so I thought it was a great opportunity to do it. So I'm going to use both the vacuum and the blower. And it, like I said, it's quite common for dogs to be scared of things like vacuums. A lot of the times it's because people are just bastards and they torment a dog with a vacuum. They think it's a great lark to chase a dog with a vacuum while it's going and stick the vacuum up against the dog's skin. Because like I said, frankly, they're bastards and they think it's fun. And the problem is the dog is actually truly terrified when this happens. A dog doesn't like a lot of noise coming, especially a pup. He doesn't like that sudden noise and then there's a movement coming at them. And so initially they might think it's fun. They're chasing the thing and you turn around and you hit your dog with, you know, with the vacuum on and suck at the dog, and suddenly it becomes terrified. It's not funny and it creates a whole range of problems for a dog. The first 12 or 18 months of a dog's life should be filled with positives and not negatives, because that's what sets a dog up for a lifetime. The other problem is people just don't think. You know, we've all got jobs to do, we've got, you know, housework chores to do and work, and we lead busy lives. So we get a pup, we bring it home, we get out, and without thinking, we pull the vacuum out, and we vacuum, and the dog goes, whoa! And it's just terrified by the noise. Now, not all dogs are. Some dogs handle it better than others, and a lot's to do with the experience, but some dogs just don't. And people come up, and they vacuum right up next to their dog, and the dog chases, and they vacuum after it, and chase after it, and things like that. And again, you get this scared, anxious dog. Or just, even if it's not scared and anxious, it ends up being terribly overstimulated and becomes out of control. And the dog gets older, suddenly people go, oh, this isn't cute anymore, this is a pain in the ass. And they want to fix it. So the smart thing is not to do it in the first place. The smart thing is if you get a pup, you desensitize it to these things, because these things are going to be there day after day. And so, you know, for that very little time it'll take from a new pup to desensitize it, because it hasn't had a bad experience, and to give it good experiences, saves you so much work later on. Most people don't believe it too late, but this will work whether or not your dog's had no experience with it, so you're going to desensitize a blank dog, so a dog that's never had a bad experience, or you're going to desensitize a dog that's had a horrible experience and is out of control, either with anxiety, fear, or overstimulation and going nuts. Remember, an anxious dog is simply an aggressive dog in waiting. So if your dog's anxious about something, it's better to fix it now, because there's that risk that the dog will bite out of fear. Alright, so what I've got is just a blower I picked up from the internet. It's a combination blower dryer. So this is what I'm going to get used to. And just a standard old cheap vacuum. So again, it doesn't really matter what they are. And even this will work with not just these. You can desensitize your dog exactly the same way against anything else that's noisy and might cause problems, such as some mixers, graters, you know, electric graters, juicers. Outside, it could be the lawnmower, the leaf blower, the chainsaw, things like that. The technique's exactly the same, and the fix is exactly the same to either, you know, work with a pup that's brand new that hasn't experienced, or one that's already afraid of it. So I'm going to work with Koji. Like I said, Koji is terrific. His lifestyle means he's got to adapt to so many things so quickly. So he's very calm, very confident, the best of times. He was a little bit skittish when I put it up, you know, went to put it up against his skin. And that's why I thought I'd go through the whole thing and desensitize. He doesn't really need desensitizing against the noise or the introduction of the vacuum, because he just doesn't fear them. But once it comes up to his skin, he does. So look, I will probably shoot this whole thing today. I think I'll have him desensitized enough today where I can move on and actually begin using those things with him. But don't kid yourself, that's not going to happen for you, and depending on how bad your dog is or isn't will also depend on how quickly you can desensitize your dog against it. It could be days, it could be weeks, it could be months. So a lot will depend on how your dog is. And like I said, it can be done right across the range for everything. So you can really get this, get your dog not anxious if it's scared of the motor mower, the leaf blower or the chainsaw, the vacuum, all of them. You can begin working on your dog and desensitize it. And if it's multiple things the dog's scared of, desensitize one thing at a time. But use the basic concept of this to protect your dog from anxiety from the other things. So distance is your best friend. So if your dog's scared of a mower, get it inside opposite end towards the mower is. If you're using a chainsaw, get your dog as far away as you possibly can from it. And so on and so forth, and then work on one thing at a time. Anyway, I hope that helps, and I hope this series helps. We'll see you in the first one.